गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, हाउ आर यू? आई एम अरविंद कुमार, ए टीचर ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मल्टीप्लीकेशन ऑफ होल नंबर्स. स्टूडेंट watch it, listen it carefully and follow the rules and regulations. So let us start the very important topic, properties of multiplication of whole numbers. Student, you know very well that multiplication is a repeated addition. When we add the same number itself, we get its short form, such as 5 + 5 + 5 is equal to, can you write, 3 × 5. So 3 × 5 is a short form to write 5 + 5 + 5. Okay, now it is clear about multiplication. Look at first property, which is known as closure property. Closure property indicates that the product of two whole numbers is always an whole number. Look, 5 × 2 is equal to 10. 5 is a whole number, student. 2 is also a whole number, and 10 is also a whole number. So closure property indicates if we multiply two whole numbers, we get a whole number. Clear? Now next one, commutative property. Student, are you looking at commutative property? Commutative property indicates that whatever the order of the numbers, that does not affect its result, their results. If we multiply any number, any two numbers in any order, we get the same result. Do you understand? Suppose 7 × 6 is equal to 6 × 7 is equal to 14. It means the change of order of the numbers does not affect its on its result. Clear? Now next one, multiplicative property of zero. It is universal. It is also known as universal property, student. As you know that when we multiply any number by zero, you get zero. Yes, when you multiply any number by zero, you get zero. Look here, I am writing here, A multiply zero is equal to zero. 0 × A is equal to 0. 2 × 0 is equal to 0. And 0 × 7 is equal to 0. Okay. So this property indicates, multiplicative property of 0, that when we multiply any numbers, we get 0 as result. स्टूडेंट वन इमेजिनरी क्वेश्चन कम्स हियर. लुक, इट वॉज आस्क्ड इन द सम एग्जामिनेशन. लुक हियर, समवन हैज रिटन 735 × 1095 × 0 × 3505 एंड अ टीचर आस्क्स व्हाट इज द रिजल्ट ऑफ द गिवन और रिटन नंबर्स. You have to reply it within 10 seconds. What can you speak? Speak a slang? Yes, yes, very good, very good. You have spoken the right. That is zero. Yes, 735 × 1095 × 0 × 3505 is result is zero. Okay, the numbers are so many and only I have to multiply, but we remember that zero must be a number. It should not be the place of any number. It should be a whole number. Okay, student? So, it is the property of zero. Now, multiplicative property of one. In a very simple manner, I am going to tell you the multiplicative property of 1. 1 is known as the multiplicative identity. 1 is also called the multiplicative identity. Do you understand? Why? Because when we multiply any number by 1, we get the number itself. It means 1 does not affect any number. When you multiply the number written in billion or million by 1, you will get the same number. Look here, 7355 × 1 = 7355. Here I have multiplied 7355 by 1. What have I got? My dear student, speak. Yes, 7355. I have got 7355. There is no hesitation. Now, the next property, which is very important, is distributive law of multiplication. Student, I want to tell before doing this, I want to tell you some of the important things related to the above property, closure property. It means whole numbers are closed under multiplication. Closure property is applied for whole numbers. Do you understand? The next one, commutative property. Commutative property is also applied for whole numbers. It means the change of the order of the numbers does not affect on its result. It means whole numbers are commutative. What have I said, student? I have said whole numbers are commutative under multiplication. Have you understood? property of one, you know it. Multiplicative property of zero, you know it. But about distributive law of multiplication, the two things happen here. The one is distributive property of multiplication over addition, and the other is distributive property of multiplication over subtraction. Student, it is very important property, and I will explain this property very nicely and very conveniently. So be careful about it. By taking A is equal to sum, B is equal to sum, and C is equal to sum numbers, you can check. First you can check it. Student, first you can check it. I am okay, students. Let A is equal to 5, B is equal to 4, and C is equal to 3. Then A multiply B plus C is equal to what? A multiply, instead of B, you have to write 4 plus 3. Yes? What? Here you have to write 5. A stands for 5, B stands for 4, and C stands for 3. Okay? So 5 multiply 7 is equal to 35. Okay? 5 multiply 7 is equal to 35. Now the next one, that is, look here. A multiply B plus A multiply C. Same can be written. It means A multiply B plus C can be written as A multiply B plus and A multiply C. Okay? Now look here. A multiply B. It means 5 multiply 4. Okay? 5 multiply 4. Plus A multiply C, it means 5 multiply 3. 5 4 is 20, plus 5 3 is 15. The result is 35. So look here also the result is 35. Here also the result is 35. I have understood, students. So you can write that A multiply B plus C is equal to A multiply B plus A multiply C. The next property, that is over subtraction. Look here, this is also implemented for subtraction. In subtraction, look here, student, in subtraction, look here. Just I have written A multiply B minus C is equal to A multiply B is 4 and C is 3. Okay? Instead of, you have to write 5 because we have taken 5, and now this one will be 5 multiply 1, that is 1. Have you understood? Have you understood, students? Now look here, A multiply B minus A multiply C. I have written A multiply B minus A multiply C. Okay, so A multiply B, instead of A, you have to write 5 into 4 minus 5 into 3. Okay. That will be 5 to the 20 minus 5 3 4 15 20 minus 15 is equal to 5 okay 20 minus 15 is equal to 5 so you have observed here that this is equal to this so distributive property of multiplication over addition and distributive property of multiplication over subtraction I have written that means distributive property is applied both addition and subtraction in the form of multiplication you have to keep it in mind have understood students in the next class I will teach you the correct implementation of distributive property by taking some of the problems thank you very much